During a raid today morning, police discovered a house in Nabweru, Nansana municipality in Wakiso district, where the suspects are said to have been making the improvised explosive devices. Twelve wine bottles, binder nails, sugar, charcoal dust, jerry cans of petrol, matchboxes, blasting caps, dynamites and candle wicks are just a few of the recovered items. In a combined operation between the UPDF and the police in Nabweru North, Nansana Division, Nansana Municipality and Wakiso District, at least six people have been detained after they were allegedly found in possession of the improvised explosive devices. The suspects include Muhammad Kalyango, Abdul Katamba, Arafat Sali, Emmanuel Asimwe, Hamid Muyondi, among others. According to security, the explosive devices were to allegedly be used in the planned nationwide demonstrations that were called for by the Uganda freedom activists to protest against economic hardships and corruption in the country.
Other operations are going on to ensure all these cells are identified and the perpetrators are arrested. Therefore, we have to call upon the members of the public to be extra vigilant.
And this is after they received information that suspected terrorists had a camp here where they were assembling and making IEDs. These are locally made bombs that were going to be used within the city center to cause mayhem.
During the arrests, one of the suspects, Hamid Muyonde, was shot in the foot. Luke Owesigire, the deputy spokesperson of the Kampala Metropolitan Police, explained that the incident occurred when one of the army officers failed to follow the protocols and accidentally discharged his gun, hitting the suspect.
The suspect you've seen moving away with a wound in his foot. This is after an accident occurred while in the vehicle as they were preparing to drive away. One of the officers in the vehicle who had not carried out normal safety precautions, making sure that his gun was safe, probably mistakenly discharged a bullet, a stray bullet, which injured Muyondi Hamid, 37 years of age. We have rushed him to a hospital for treatment, but we are hopeful that the injury is minor, and we are waiting for the outcomes from the medical side where it has been taken.
Security has today been heightened in Kampala and its surroundings to keep the protesters away. Police have warned against protests in the city, terming them unlawful. Meanwhile, police say they have arrested eight people for organizing the recently announced national economic shutdown. Enanga says these were organized to destabilize the country through illegal protests and violence.
But we simply want to urge them, instead of encouraging these unlawful protests and so on, it is better for them to participate in constructive economic reforms.
Kampala City Traders Association, KASITA, have advised their traders to distance themselves from the said protests.
So any activity which can affect the continuity and operation of businesses, we think is not called for at this time.
Report by Juliet Namuaya for the news.